Hey everyone, this is Kat West from High End Systems.
And Kensy Clone from ESP Vision. We're going to talk about how to network your Wholehog console over to computer running ESP Vision.
This is my favorite visualizer, and it's the one that I use in all of my console training classes. Here's Kensy with a quick overview of ESP Vision.
Thank you, Kat. ESP Vision provides the tools for lighting designers to create their design in a virtual world prior to having access to the live rig. This can be used as a creative tool for design, a time saver when access to the live rig is limited, and a cost saving tool when you need to pre-program your show without access to the live rig.
This video will illustrate three possible network connections that you could choose from to connect your Wholehog console, whether it's a Wholehog 3, a full bore, a Hog IPC running Hog 3, or even Hog 3 PC. To ESP Vision over a network. No matter which scenario you choose, you will need the latest visualizer connectivity drivers installed on your ESP Vision computer. These can be downloaded from flyingpig.com. Additionally, you may find that you need to disable the firewall on your computer when networking to the console. If we set the console up as a DHCP server, then the console will distribute all of the network settings for us. In this scenario, we can connect the console to the computer using a single crossover cable, or with a network switch and patch cables. To set up your console, click the Setup key and select Control Panel from your main toolbar. Click the Network tab. If you're using Hog 3 PC, ensure that your Hognet adapter is set for your computer's Ethernet port. Leave Use Default IP Settings checked and select Enable DHCP and Boot Server. Then click OK.
On the ESP computer, access the Network Connections window from the Control Panel. Locate your local area connection and right-click on it. From the drop-down, click Properties. In this window, select Internet Protocol TCP/IP and click Properties. In the new window, clicking Obtain an IP address automatically will allow the computer to listen for the IP and subnet information being distributed by the console.
Another way to network from console to visualizer is to manually set compatible IP and subnet settings. The connection can be via a single crossover cable or through a network switch with patch cables. To set up your console, click the Setup key and select Control Panel from your main toolbar. Click the Network tab. If you're using Hog 3 PC, ensure that your Hognet adapter is set for your computer's Ethernet port. When selecting Use Default IP Settings, the console will assign itself as 172.31.0.1 with a subnet of 255.255.0.0. This is universal over the entire Wholehog OS product line. Since we're going to go with the default IP settings, you'll want to click Enable Boot Server Only and then press OK.
On the ESP computer, access the Network Connections window from the Control Panel. Locate your local area connection and right-click on it. From the drop-down, click Properties. In the new window, select Internet Protocol TCP/IP and click Properties. In this window, we need to enter an IP range that will be compatible with the default range of the Wholehog. I'm going to enter 172.31.0.2 as my IP. This will automatically set the same subnet as the console, 255.255.0.0.
If you're placing a pre-configured router between your console and ESP computer, then you'll want to connect using patch cables. In this setup, the router will distribute the network settings to both the console and the computer. To set up your console, click the Setup key and select Control Panel from the main toolbar. Click the Network tab. If you're using Hog 3 PC, ensure that your Hognet adapter is set for your computer's Ethernet port. Click Obtain an IP address using DHCP. This will tell the console to listen for the router's network information. Click OK to save the settings.
On the ESP computer, access the Network Connections window from the Control Panel. Locate your local area connection and right-click on it. From the drop-down, click Properties. In this window, select Internet Protocol TCP/IP and click Properties. In the new window, clicking Obtain an IP address automatically will allow the computer to listen for the IP and subnet information being distributed by the router.
Once you have your network connection set, you're ready to connect to ESP Vision. Make sure your console is logged into the show file that matches your ESP file. Then launch ESP.
From the DMX source window, select Hog 3 and click OK. When ESP opens, you'll see the Wholehog connectivity driver launch. This will show the status of the connection between console and visualizer. Once the outputs are active, you are ready to start programming.